everyone. We are Team Rest of the Story. I am Abby Mergenmeyer. I'm a graduate student in Journalism School.
Hi, I'm Jordan Mess. I'm an undergraduate student in Computer Science major.
And I'm Tom Hausman. I'm an undergrad Journalism major. We are also on team. We've got Hannah Klarner, who is a graduate student in the Journalism School as well. And we are mentored by Evan Golub, who's a CS professor.
So how we told the rest of the story using 360 content. A lot of the times when you see a still photograph, sometimes still photos can be manipulated. Good journalists obviously don't do this, but you know, sometimes there are ethics violations. So using 360-degree content, you can see an entire atmosphere, what's going on around when the 360-degree photo is taken. So we, first of all, found ways that we could kind of integrate using 360-degree cameras into our normal workflows while out in the field. So we use mostly little Ricoh Theta 360-degree cameras. And one thing that Evan used was a helmet with a rig set up at the top. but we actually also have some people used a smaller Nikon 360-degree camera, which made you look a little less like a Teletubby. And then for myself, since I'm more of a print journalist, had a monopod that you would attach the 360 to, and basically, in one of the videos we'll show later, you can see me wearing it. And it's nice, so I have both my hands free to like take notes, talk to people, while that is recording basically over my shoulder all the time. And also having the camera above your head on the monopod helps kind of keep the reporter out of the shot so much. You could definitely, you know, when you scroll down the video, see the top of the head, but it's not as obstructive. And then for Tom, who uses the DSLR.
So Hannah and I are both photographers. The technique that we developed for us is we have this bracket mount here, and the 360 would go on top, and this lifts the 360 camera above the photographer's head while they're using it. If you look back, Evan's got a setup with the Nikon 360. It lifts it up above. You can still see a lot of the photographer, like when they're looking into the camera and stuff like that, but it does lift it up, and it helps kind of give you a taller perspective above any crowds that you're in. So that was kind of how we developed. We're trying to find ways for people to use these while still maintaining their full mobility that they would be using in their day-to-day job.
Right, and then briefly, one of the challenges we faced when trying to collect 360-degree content was, you know, whether or not venues, organizations would actually allow you to film using a 360-degree camera. There's one instance this semester when we tried to shoot at RFK Stadium for the She Believes Women's National Team Soccer Cup. And it was kind of weird. Hannah, one of our photojournalists, was out on the field shooting video, had the bracket, the little camera on top. And I actually was working with US Soccer's communications team that evening. And so when I was on that side, all of a sudden heard someone from US Soccer run in and say, "There's a journalist out there with a VR camera on top." And everyone in the room was impressed. They're like, "Oh, like that's really crazy. VR, that's cool." But at the same time, they also were saying, "Oh, like I don't think she's allowed to do that. You know, we got to tell her to take that down." So I shot Hannah a text saying, "Hey, just look out. Like, you know, put it away real quick." So she did, and you know, nothing came of it. But that was just interesting that they didn't have any protocol set and didn't seem to know what to do with it. And after doing a little bit of research, a lot of venues, a lot of organizations don't specify VR, you know, collection or anything, just because it's very new content. I think I'm taking a lot of time.
Jordan.
If you just want to like touch on that.
Oh, right, okay. So on the user side of our project, for one of our tech goals was to augment news articles. So we have simple HTML code that lets you do this. You can click on a picture or a link in the article, and the 360 photo or 360 video will appear in the flow of the article so that the reader can still interact with the article normally and have the 360 content and not be interrupted while they're viewing that.
All right. We'll touch on the other things in that slide as we move on. So here is an example of some of the content that we did collect. So first is Marked for Science. Here you can see Evan collected this using smaller 360 camera on a helmet. And yes, so there you see the still photo. You click to see a still 360 degree photo of everything else. You can kind of tell where, or the subjects of his photo, like where they were. You can see Beaker in there. And then if you, and then if you scroll down a bit, there is a video.
With the enthusiastic crowd.
So we have hyperlinks within this article, and the hyperlinks obviously come about to provide 360 content and show you, you know, basically transparency and proof that what the reporter wrote did actually happen. And then next, for the Gymkhana performance, I went using the shoulder like rig with the monopod and just kind of shot some photos with my phone, as you can see there. And there's some 360 degree video. Click on that. Yeah. So here I said where the hyperlink is the beginning of an interview I did. And if you click on the link, you can see me actually beginning to conduct the interview right there. So you can kind of, that transparency also works there, but you can actually see this girl actually said this to me. I'm taking notes on it. That's how that works. Not only does this 360 degree content help give the viewer a true transparent sense for the atmosphere at the event, but it also allows people to get a better sense of what it feels like to walk in the steps of a journalist.
So that's kind of a lot of what I did this semester, is walking around with this camera rig. I was working with CNS in DC, and I just bring it out to events, protests, events in the Capitol, let's do the U.S. Capitol one, let's go with this one. So this video here, gotta not log in. This is during, so this was during Trump's address to Congress a few months ago. This was in Statuary Hall, or not Statuary Hall, in the old House room, as all these people are walking in. Around the 18-second mark coming up here, you can see Justice John Roberts walk in. And so this is one of those instances where, like, you can post this photo of John Roberts walking in and say, here he is, but then you can post this video and it'll share and everyone can see, like, oh, this is a huge room that he's in, and kind of get the full context for where they're walking and kind of the grandiose nature. This is one of the issues, is like, you are always in the shot with 360. I had a lot longer hair back then. There's a lot of like looking into the camera. So stuff like that kind of is present. But as long as you're making sure the camera is oriented in the right way, for the most part, it won't be looking at you as often. And that's up to the user at that point, whether they want to see me or not. And then let's do the parts. Okay, let's move on. So one of the other groups that we worked with was the Berry School. We kind of went out there and we eventually wanted to do more workshops with them, but we kind of had to gauge interest with them first. So Hannah, Evan, and I made a fake protest with them. You know, we gave them different colors and said, okay, you're supporting green, you're supporting blue, and we had to pick certain colors so it wasn't political, and we just wanted to make sure that they're doing it. And we gave Hannah a podium, and she sat up there and gave a fake speech, and I took photos of the event. And then throughout the rest of the event, I edited them, and we were able to show them, here's Hannah talking, you know, it looks like there's a bunch of blue supporters here, but if you look at the 360, everyone else in the crowd is with green, and like, so it was kind of a good way to show them, like, the real purpose of this, that you can really gain a lot more information from the 360 than you get with just still photos. And they all seem pretty interested in it. We did another experience with them where they could view through VR goggles, but we haven't really been able to get back yet.
Okay, so we talked to you about the user side, but as for the journalist side, we wanted to develop a software tool to help them. If you want to hit, yeah. So basically what this does is if you have a folder of regular photos on your computer and a folder of 360 photos or videos on your computer, our software tool is able to match each regular photo with the 360 photo that was taken right before and the 360 photo that was taken right after, and then it packages them up and copies them to a destination of your choosing. And so the journalist is easily able to find all the images that they need. And our future work would include adding a video frame grabber, which would allow them, instead of having a photo before and after, to actually grab a 360 photo exactly from the video.
Yeah, we'll cut it there. Sorry, that was a little long. Thanks for having us. Any questions?